My dear brothers and sisters, this month of Ramadan is a blessed month, as you know. We have been living this blessed month, living in this month, with the grace of Allah, His mercy, that He enabled us to get this month and to live this beautiful, blessed days and nights of the Ramadan. Look at today, we'll be praying two people janazah. They are missing now. They could not complete the month of Ramadan. We hope and pray, may Allah give us tawfiq to complete this month, inshallah. Look, those who missed, how fortunate we are in Ramadan. Many people who are clever, who are wise, who are, you know, fortunate, they are competing, they are in race. How to get more of the virtue of this month throughout the different nature of the ibadah, from the fasting to the salah, taraweeh, sadaqat, zakat, many other ibadah they are doing and giving. Look at the beautiful month. We do many ibadah here. We are tired already whole day by fasting, not eating. You're hungry. You are thirsty. Even a drop of water you don't drink. Then whenever iftar comes, you take iftar, you grab your iftar, and you again rush and run quickly to come to the masjid to pray in jama'ah. Even you don't miss the any salah, the all salah, you come to the masjid, you see masjid is full, mashallah, alhamdulillah. And in taraweeh, after whole day is tiring, fasting, you are attending the masjid, mashallah. You continue to pray even 20 rak'ah with the imam. Subhanallah, mashallah. How you got this energy? Try other day. A day you are not eating, you are hungry, so tired. I don't think you'll be doing 50% of the ibadah you do in the month of Ramadan while you're fasting. Any other day you cannot do it, I challenge you. This is a special bonus from Allah. A special sanction from Allah. The blessing, the barakah come to us. We must appreciate Allah, must say alhamdulillah. We must get, let us make our bucket of righteous deeds are full in this month. We don't miss any small opportunity. We don't have the gossiping, you know, chit-chat and all this WhatsApp and Facebook and all the social media. We try to cut down longer phone calls, free call. No, even though it is free, I don't care. I'm conscious of my time is very valuable. Zikr, dua, istighfar, recitation of Quran. This is the season for those who are looking for Jannah. While we are busy with all these, another ibadah comes in this month for many people, paying zakah. Although you can pay zakah in any month, but why most of the people choose Ramadan for zakah? Because of two reasons. One is, it is any reward, any good deeds reward is multiplied many times in this month, up to 700. And also, that calculating zakah is not based on the Gregorian calendar, the lunar month, Islamic calendar, because the other one is, the secular calendar is 11 days more. So we'll be missing 11 days zakah. Therefore, we need to calculate according to the Arabic month, Islamic month, the Hijra month. We don't know in the whole of the year when Rabi al-Thani come, Jamadi al-Ula come, we don't know. Sometimes we don't know the name of the month even. So to calculate that is difficult. Therefore, Ramadan, nobody will miss it. Who doesn't know this month is in Arabic what it is called? Everybody knows it is Ramadan. Everybody knows what is the day of Ramadan today, what date is today. So that's why it's easy to calculate. Zakat is one of the biggest ibadah, fardun, compulsory Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made for us. He mentioned in the Quran this ibadah 82 times with the salah. Aqimu salah wa atu zakah. Establish the salah and give zakah. This alms zakah is third pillar of Islam. And this zakah is not a tax. I know you feel very painful when it is giving tax, big amount, or any penalty you pay. If somebody is having good income and 40% is taking tax, it's very painful. But subhanAllah, zakat is not that. It is ibadah. You obey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is barakah for you. It is increase, it is numu. It is ziyadah of your barakah, blessing in your wealth. Although a portion is given out, but that will not make you are losing money. By Allah, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, never sadaqah decreased the wealth. Never ever decrease. Have full yaqeen, firm belief in the words of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and with happy mind, wholeheartedly, with sincere intention, pay zakah, feel free. You thank Allah that Allah has given you tawfiq to pay zakah. Allah didn't make you are receiving zakah. Doesn't it deserve Allah's appreciation? And you feel painful, oh, if I have 10,000 pounds, I have to give 250 pounds, decreasing my wealth. You don't have iman. The reward, look into the reward. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Zariyat, إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونَ آخِذِينَ مَا آتَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ مُحْسِنِينَ كَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ وَبِالْأَسْحَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقُّ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. Indeed, the righteous will be among gardens and spring in Jannah, in paradise, accepting what their Lord has given them. Indeed, they were before that in this dunya doers of good. They were doers of good. They used to sleep but little of the night. And in the hours before dawn, they would ask forgiveness, praying to Allah to give them Jannah, to forgive their sin. And from their wealth was the right of the needy petitioner and the deprived. So they knew in their wealth there is a right of those who are deprived, who are poor. So if you have 1,000 pounds, your right is only 975 pounds. 25 pounds is in your pocket, but its owner is the poor, those who are deprived. It is their wealth. Allah has given to your pocket to test you. Are you greedy, holding it, or are you giving it? If you give it, it's not only you comply with command of Allah, you deserve so much reward. Jannah, paradise is waiting for you. So it is so much rewardful. We need to go to Jannah. The zakah is here to help us to go to Jannah. This is ibadah maliyah. This is some sort of ibadah, the financial ibadah. Ibadah with in our wealth. We have physical ibadah, fasting, salah, hajj. We have ibadah of the mal, the wealth Allah given to us. That is the ibadah we do. It is worship of Allah. It is blessing. It increases wealth. It has so much benefit, as Allah said also in the Quran, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُطَهِّرُهُمْ وَتُذَكِّيهِمْ بِهَا وَصَلِّ عَلَيْهِمْ إِنَّ صَلَاتَكَ سَكَنٌ لَهُمْ. Take from their wealth a charity by which you purify them and cause them increase. So it is purification of your own soul, own nafs, because a nafs has greed of wealth, and this is impurity. By giving zakah, we love wealth. أَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. All of us love the wealth and money. So this love of the wealth and money is impurity. And when we give zakah, it purifies it. And it is also tazkiyah, zakah is also numu. It increases. So this is the barakah of the zakah. That's why فالزكاه في الاسلام طهره للنفس ونماء للمال وعبوديه لله سبحانه وتعالى واحسان للفقراء والمساكين وفيها تثبيت اواصر موده الرحمه بين الخلق. So much benefit of zakah, purification of your soul, increase and barakah more in your wealth, and you do obey Allah, His command, your ibadah, worshipping Allah, and it is doing charity to the poor, the needy, and it helps to have the social care in the society. Those who are deprived is a guarantee of the social care, which create the love and respect to each other, and not hatred and jealousy from the poor to the rich. And this will be given back to you in the akhirah, even in dunya. As Allah said, وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُهُ وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ. Whatever thing you spend in His cause, zakat or sadaqah, whatever, He will compensate it. He'll compensate it in this dunya. And He is the best of providers. مَا نَقَسَ مَالُمْ عَبْدٍ مِنْ صَدَقَةٍ. A servant's wealth will not decrease from charity, as he heard earlier. Not giving zakah is a heinous crime. Punishment is very severe. As in hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ مَالًا فَلَمْ يُؤَدِّ زَكَاتَهُ مُسْفِلَ لَهُ مَالُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ شُجَاعًا أَقْرَى لَهُ زَبِبَتَان يَتَوَقُّهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ ثُمَّ يَأْخُذُ بِالْهِزِمَتَيْنِ يَعْنِي بِشِدْقَيْ ثُمَّ يَقُولُ أَنَا مَالُكَ أَنَا كَنْزُكَ ثُمَّ تَلَا صلى الله عليه وسلم. قاله تعالى ولا يحسبن الذين يبخلون بما آتاهم الله من فضله هو خيرا لهم بل هو شر لهم سيطوقون ما بخلوا به يوم القيامة. So there is a verse of Quranic ayah in Surah Ali Imran 180 where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and let not those who greedily withhold what Allah has given them of His bounty, of wealth, ever think that is better for them. Rather, it is worse for them if they don't pay zakah. Their necks will be encircled by what they withheld on the day of judgment. How it will be encircling their neck. It came in hadith of Bukhari, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever Allah has given him wealth and he did not pay zakah of that wealth will be turned into a severe, serious kind of python, big snake, dangerous one, poisonous one, and encircled whole body of him from toe to neck. And when it come to the neck, coming, making its head, snake's head towards his face, and it will be biting on his cheek, saying, "Ana maluka, ana kanzuka." So poisonous, so painful of each bite. You have to test this bite of your wealth if you don't pay zakah. Another Quranic verse says, وَالَّذِينَ يَكْنِزُونَ الذَّهَبَ وَالْفِضَّةِ وَلَا يُنْفِقُونَهَا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ يَوْمَ يُحْمَى عَلَيْهَا فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمَ فَتُكْوَى بِهَا جِبَاهُهُمْ وَجُنُوبُهُمْ وَظُهُورُهُمْ هَذَا مَا كَنَزْتُمْ لِأَنفُسِكُمْ فَذُوقُوا مَا كُنْتُمْ تَكْنِزُونَ. And those who hoard gold and silver and spend it not in the way of Allah, doesn't pay zakah, give them tidings of a painful punishment. The day when it will be heated, all this money will be turned to the bars, iron bar, metal bar, will be heated in the fire of hell, and seared will be their foreheads chopped, their flanks and their backs, and it will be said, this is what you hoarded for yourself. So taste what you used to hoard. We have to be very careful. Are we paying zakah properly? We need to know details. Inshallah, we'll have zakah training session seminar tomorrow, Saturday after Asr in English, and Sunday after Dhuhr in Bangla. We'd like to see you attend and learn how you pay your zakah, how you calculate it, who must pay, who are not supposed to pay. My dear brothers and sisters, another important financial ibadah coming in the end of month of Ramadan, that is fitra, zakatul fitr. Sadaqatul fitr, we need to pay before Eid, after Ramadan. It should be reaching to the poor before Eid. But many people pay fitra here when they come to pray Salatul Eid. If you pay here in the Eid time, how it will reach to them? It will take a couple of days to go to them. Therefore, it is essential to pay before Eid. Although some of the scholars said it is only for in the Eid day or day before Eid. But many of the scholars said, Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah said, it is allowed to pay even before Ramadan starts. Imam Ash-Shafi'i rahmatullah said, it is allowed to pray when Ramadan starts. So it is already started. You can pay it now. You can send it now to back home to other charity organization. You can give to our masjid. So it will be received, and inshallah, it will be sent to the different countries where there are many poor, refugees are suffering. So please don't delay with your fitra until Eid day comes. Please pay from now on. May Allah give you tawfiq. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم وأقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا واتوبوا إليه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. وأصلي وأسلم على أفضل الأنبياء وسيد المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، عباد الله، اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. واعلموا أن أحسن الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. وعليكم بالجماعة فإن يد الله مع الجماعة. فصلوا على البشير النذير، إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد. رضي الله عن الأربعة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين الذين قضوا بالحق وبه كانوا يعدلون، أبي بكر عمر وعثمان وعلي، وعن سائر أصحاب نبيك محمد أجمعين، وعن الذين يتبعونهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم برحمتك ومنك وكرمك وإحسانك يا رب العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها، أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها مولاها. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك الجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك النار. اللهم رحمتك نرجو فلا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين، وأصلح لنا شؤوننا كلها، لا إله إلا أنت يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث. اللهم ارحم على عبادك المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انصرهم بنصرك المبين، احفظهم بحفظك المتين. اللهم اهلك اعداءك اعداء الدين الذين يحاربون دينك ويقاتلون اولياءك. اللهم خذهم اخذ عزيز مقتدر. اللهم انزل عليهم باسك الذي لا ترده عن القوم المجرمين. عباد الله، اتقوا الله واذكروه يذكركم واشكروه يزدكم، ولذكر الله اكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. واقم الصلاه.